Hello and welcome to this session in which we will discuss the topic of petty cash. This topic is covered in intermediate accounting as well as the CPA exam. Whether you are an accounting student or a CPA candidate, I strongly suggest you take a look at my website, farhatlectures.com. I don't replace your CPA review course. I'm a useful addition to your CPA review course. I explain the material differently. I'll give you the theory behind the concept, which in turn will help you understand the material better. Your risk with me is 1 month of subscription. You give it a try. You like it, you keep it. Otherwise, you cancel. Your potential gain is adding 10 to 15 points to your CPA exam score. If not for anything, take a look at my website to find out how well or not well your university doing on the CPA exam. I do have resources for other college courses such as intermediate accounting, advanced accounting, taxation, governmental, basic accounting, so on and so forth. My supplemental CPA review courses are aligned with your Becker, Wiley, Roger, and Glean, so it's very easy to go back and forth between my material and your CPA review course. Also, you'll have access to all the AI CPA multiple choice questions over the past 10 years. Approximately 1,500 questions with detailed solutions. If you haven't connected with me on LinkedIn, please do so. Take a look at my LinkedIn recommendation, like this recording, share it with others, connect with me on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and Reddit. So what is petty cash? Well, petty cash is actual cash used for small expenses. Now, why do we pay with cash? Now, in general, you should never pay in cash. We should always have a check for cash disbursement. And the reason is simple. A check will keep a record of how much, when, who, and how we paid. So it gives you answers to all what you need to know for an audit. But for conveniency and for expediency and for small expenditure, we might pay in a form of a check. And some vendors only accept a check. For example, if you buy from your local restaurant, if you're buying meals for your employees, they're working overtime during lunch, well, maybe the restaurant only takes cash. You cannot buy them, you cannot give them a check. Or if something happened, you want to buy supplies real quick and you don't want to go through the check procedures, you don't want to go through all the internal control to issue a check, you'll have some cash on hand. So the company establishes this petty cash fund for those type of expenses. And they will designate what we call a cash custodian, a person who's in charge of that cash. And that person will not disperse any cash without a valid receipt. And that receipt has to have a business use. So the custodian will make a list of every time they issue money for an expense, expense two, expense one, and they will have the dollar amount and they will add this amount and they will have a receipt for that. At all time, the receipts plus the cash on hand equal to the petty cash fund. So once that petty cash fund is established, it has to be that certain amount. It does not change. This is called impressed fund. It means the amount is always the same. The amount equal to the receipt plus the cash. So if I don't have the cash, I must have a receipt to support my cash disbursement. Now, any difference, and sometimes differences could happen where we could have more cash or less cash than the petty cash fund. I mean by cash plus receipts, they could be more or less. Simply put, we could have made a mistake, disperse more money, or when we return the change to someone, we return the wrong change, or the other person gave us the wrong change, we might have more cash or less cash than the petty cash fund. If that's the case, we're gonna put them in an account called cash over and cash short, cash over slash short. And this account is considered either a revenue or other revenue or other expenses. It should be a very small amount anyway. So once we run low on cash, receipts are submitted to the controller or to the AP for reimbursement and the journal entry purposes. So this is what happened. Once the custodian feels we're down to like $50, okay, now it's time to submit this list of expenses plus the receipts, ask for reimbursement so they can give us the check and we move on with our life. And the petty cash fund can be increased or decreased depending on what we need to know. The best way to illustrate this petty cash is to actually work an example. Now on my farhatlectures.com, I have multiple choice exercises. You can go there, but I'm gonna work an example now to show you how this all fits together. So let's work an example to illustrate this concept. So the company decided to establish a petty cash fund for $500. Simply put, the company wants to have on hand in one of their offices in New York City, let's just for example, $500. So they will send a check to that office and they will tell the cash custodian to go to the bank and cash the check. The entry will be debit petty cash, credit cash for $500. They're both assets. Simply put, we took the cash from the bank account and we kept it at the office. Now we have $500 in actual cash. And what I mean by actual cash is actual cash, just cash as is in this picture. Once we establish this fund, we keep it at 500 until we decided to reduce it. Now, again, we assign a custodian, and the custodian will only give money out with a receipt and a valid business purpose. So the custodian made the following disbursement for business purposes for a particular month: supply $75, meal expense $145, cleaning expense. And the custodian counted the cash on hand and they had $40 on hand. Well, hold on a second. Let's count this. We have $75. We paid $75 for the supplies. We paid $145 for the meal, and the employees were working overtime, and we had to call someone to do a quick cleanup. There was a spill at the office. Therefore, if we take 75 plus 145 plus 235, that's equal to $455, and we still have $40 in cash on hand, two 20s, $40, that's equal to $495. Hold on a second, we're supposed to have $500. Well, we don't. We are short $5. Why we are short, I don't know. Maybe we tipped the cleaning person that came to the cleanup, or we tipped the delivery person that delivered the food. I don't know. There was some problem that we are cash short of $5. And what we do is we submit this report to the controller or to the AP to reimburse us, because we're only down to $40 in cash. At this point, the AP or the controller will make the following entry: supplies expense, meal expense, cleaning expense, cash over and cash short. Now, this is an expense because it's $5. Then they will give us a check for $460. We're going to go ahead, cash the check, bring $460 back to the office, and we have $40 already. Guess what? We're back to $500, what we started with. Now, the management decided that the petty cash fund is excessive for this company, and management decided to reduce it to $350. So rather than having $500 as a petty cash fund, we're going to bring it down to $350. What does that mean? It means we need to reduce it by $150. Simply put, we ask the cash custodian to go to the bank, deposit $150 in our business bank account, and we'll make the following entry: we debit cash $150, credit petty cash $150. Now the petty cash fund is at $350. We started with $500. We decided to reduce it by $150. The petty cash is $350. The best way to learn this concept is to go to my website, work exercises, work multiple choice questions. At the end of this recording, I'm going to remind you, whether you are an accounting student or a CPA candidate, to take a look at my website, farhatlectures.com. I don't replace your CPA review course. I can help you do better by explaining the material, by giving you additional resources. The CPA exam is worth it. Your accounting career is worth it. Invest in yourself. Invest in your career. Good luck. Study hard. And of course, stay safe.